Thank you for watching videos by Jeff Sebelius and LandAndAirPhotos.com. Today I'm going to take you on a walkthrough of the setup of the Fimi X8 SE 2020. If you plan to buy the Fimi X8 SE 2020, or you need accessories for the Fimi, like a gimbal guard, leg extensions, or a landing pad, please support this channel and use the links in the description below to buy from Banggood or Amazon. I've been looking forward to this episode for a while. I ordered the Fimi X8 SE 2020. I'm going to just call it the Fimi from now on. I ordered the Fimi in April, I believe, and it finally got here in August. And so I'm looking forward to getting this thing set up so I can take it out for a first flight tomorrow. So anyway, let's walk through the process for setting up the Fimi. I'm new to this, so I'm learning as you are, because I've never used a Fimi product before. But the first step is to charge your batteries, and that's pretty much standard for any new drone. You don't want to go into a setup process with a half-charged battery on your drone and on your controller. So make sure you plug these things in and get a full charge on each one of them, so you're good to go for the install. While your batteries are charging, that's a good time to install the app for the Fimi, which is the Fimi Navi 2020. And you can find it in the Play Store or the iOS Store or whatever the different places are for downloading apps. You can also use your smart device to scan the QR code on the back of this booklet, which comes with the drone. Now, there's another copy of this barcode inside the box for the Fimi, and I tried scanning that and my phone did not take me to the right place. But when I tried scanning it here on the QR code on the booklet, it worked just fine. Of course, it also goes without saying that as your batteries are charging, that's a good time to read the manual. You can actually find a full-scale manual, or a better, more comprehensive manual, on the Fimi website and support. I would provide a link, but these links tend to change over time. So I'll put a link to the Fimi website, and then you can navigate to support and downloads for this device. You find the manual there and download it. And read that while your batteries are charging, so you're prepared for what this drone is going to throw at you that's different than other drones. And there are some things that are different. Okay, we've read the manual, we've charged the batteries on our devices, and we are ready to move on to the next step. And the next step is to connect your smart device to the controller. And that's pretty easy to do. You'll get three different cables with the Fimi. One for the Android, one for micro USB, I think, and one for the iOS, the Lightning cable connector. I'm using an Android, so I'm going to use the USB-C connector and plug that in. And let's open the app. Now, the controller expands like this, and there's a slot for the cable to fit. Now, before we take that out, we want to remove these pegs, because once we put the device in, we won't be able to get to them. These pegs will screw into these are our sticks on the controller. So once we've connected the cable to the phone, we're just going to insert it in that little slot, pull this out, and set it right in there. That's in there very snugly. You can see that thing isn't coming out. Then there's a little compartment here on the bottom, which I'll open up, and you'll find the USB port on the bottom to plug into. So now the controller is set up with the smart device. Now we need to attach the sticks. They simply screw in here, just like any of the Mavics are set up to do. and that's good to go. Now, before we move on, remember that your smart device does need to have internet connection because it's going to be checking for firmware updates and downloading that sort of thing. So make sure that you don't have this like an airplane mode or something, because then the installation won't work properly. On at least one channel that covered the installation setup of the Fimi, they said that they had a problem with the installation process because they didn't have a media card in the slot and it wasn't properly formatted. So just to be sure, we're going to go ahead and install a media card into the drone. Shouldn't need it. There ought to be space in the drone for downloading its firmware, but we're just going to follow through with that and make sure that we're good to go. On the right side of the drone, there's a little compartment right here. It will open up, and there's the slot for the, there's a USB port, which is probably for maintaining the aircraft, something that the company uses, their support staff, something like that, or maybe there'll be a future use for it. But for right now, there is no real use for it. But above it is the slot for the media card. I'm going to put the card in and click it into place. There we go, it's now in place, and I close the compartment. That was face up, by the way. The face of the media card was pointing up to fit in there. And we can go ahead and open this thing up the rest of the way. Now, before I move on, notice that this wonderful gimbal protector that they provided is still on the drone. We're going to boot this aircraft up in a minute, so let's make sure that we take this off, because that gimbal is going to have to go through some motions as part of the startup routine. So we don't want the filter padding here to interfere with that and possibly damage the drone. So now it's swinging freely. We can set that down. All right, media card's installed, we're ready to move on. I'm going to power up the controller next. Just if you're a new drone pilot, this is just a good practice for you to get into. Every time you start your controller first, then you start your aircraft. When it comes time to shut down, you power down your aircraft, then the controller. The idea is you never have the aircraft booted up while the controller isn't powered up. Chances are infinitesimal that you'll have a problem, but potentially the aircraft could start acting crazy if it doesn't have the controller connected to it. So have the controller booted up first before the aircraft is started. So let's do that. Press it. To start it, you press it with a short press, let go, and then press and hold. Tells me to make sure my charger cable is connected, which it is. Confirms that I want to use the Navi 2020 app whenever this is connected, and I'm going to say always and OK. Now, if you didn't when you first installed the app, now you're going to be prompted to set up an account with Fimi, and it's simple. You know, they ask you for your location, then you give them a username and a password, or an email address and password, I can't remember which, and you're good to go. But you're going to have that account set up before you can move on. I've already done mine, so let's keep going. Got the drone connected. As you can see, it has powered up the, or opened up the Fimi Navi app, Navi 2020 app. There actually is another one on there called Fimi Navi, I believe. This is 2020, so we're going to stick with that version. So now we're ready to start up the aircraft. Now you notice I didn't install the props. You should, just as a good safety practice, and you're doing firmware updates or setup or anything else, don't put on props on the drone, because you're going to be turning it on and doing things with its operating system and everything else. Things could go wrong. You don't want the props on if you're doing that sort of thing. Something happens. Maybe it'll try to take off or do something crazy. So leave the props off while you're doing this kind of stuff. But let's go ahead and start the drone. Same thing as with the controller. I'm going to press the button once for short, and then I'm going to press it and hold it. You can see, I'm going to turn it around here. You can see there's a solid yellow light on the back. The indicator light is solid yellow, and that means that the controller and the drone are bound, they're connected. So our next step is just as simple as hitting enter the device. RC is in RTH mode. Okay, the switch on the controller is pointed towards home. So let's move that over. So that's no longer connected. That sends that message away. Now, we don't have any kind of message that there's a firmware update that's needs to be installed, but I'm going to tell you that it's almost certain that there is a firmware update that needs to be installed. So the first thing I want to do, I got the media card in there. First thing I want to do is format the media card. And again, this is based on what I've seen on other videos that they had a problem doing the installation and the setup because they didn't have a firmware card in or a media card in, and then the media card wasn't formatted properly and it cost them all kinds of time. So let's avoid that problem. So I'm going to hit the camera settings and I click on the third icon in the camera settings, and one of the choices is format SD card. So I'm going to hit format SD card. It's confirming. Do I want them to format it? Yep, I do. Then do it. Format's complete. Now let's hit the settings menu, come down to more, or the three dots, which I believe is more, and we have a choice for firmware upgrade or update. So I'm going to click on that and it's not seeing anything that's needed. I'm going to power down the aircraft and power down the controller and then start them back up again and see if I can force it to try to do a firmware update. Power up the controller. Power up the aircraft. And I've got a message here for a firmware download. So click on firmware download and it's downloading the firmware update. So the message there is, if you don't get a message and it doesn't tell you that to do a firmware update, power everything down, close out the app, and then reboot everything, and it should prompt you to go ahead and do the firmware update, because it's almost certain there's with a new drone like this that there's going to be some kind of firmware update. Okay, download is completed. Enter the device. Firmware update. Now we can update it. Start updating. So it didn't do it automatically, which is kind of strange. It didn't just download and then start installing the firmware update. I had to actually open the camera window and wait for a second prompt. So that's a little bit unusual. And that's all updated. So hit update completed. And we're good to go. Now I'm going to power this down and I'm going to put the other battery on there. The message on the screen while it was updating, it said do each battery separately. So there's some firmware involved with the battery as well as the drone and the controller. And we need to update any extra batteries that we have at the same time. So I'm going to do that right now. That completes the setup of the Fimi X8 SE 2020. I really hate the name of that drone. They need something a little bit that rolls a little easier off the tongue, I think. Anyway, that completes the setup on this. Now there are some calibrations that should take place, most notably the compass calibration. Anytime you set up a drone or you do a firmware update, you should calibrate the compass. You don't have to calibrate it before every flight. You don't need to calibrate it all that often unless you travel a great distance or you see weird behavior. It's doing a toilet bowl pattern as it's supposed to be hovering, or it drifts, that sort of thing. Or if the app tells you, hey, update the firmware. Okay, those are the situations you need to do it. But again, we just set this drone up. We just did a firmware update on the whole system. So we definitely need to do a compass calibration. I'm not going to do it here. I like to do that out at the site where I'm going to fly my first flight. I'm outside. I'm away from magnetic interference. Obviously, I'm inside of a house now, and there's all kinds of things around that could interfere with the calibration. So I want to do it outside. So I'm not going to do that now. So that completes my tutorial on how to set up the Fimi X8 SE 2020 for its first flight. I hope you found it helpful. If you have any questions, please post them in the comments below. I plan to do more videos on this drone. I'm going to do a full-fledged review, one of my non-fanboy reviews. I'll be doing that. I'm also going to do tutorials on how to do different things with this drone, a first flight tutorial for people who have never flown a drone before. I think those are very helpful for people. So I will have a full playlist of videos on the Fimi, and it should be on screen right now. Now, this is the first episode, so give me a chance to make more, but I will. So check out that playlist and stay tuned. Be sure to hit the subscribe button, click on the bell icon so you'll be notified when I publish again. And again, your likes and your comments are always greatly appreciated. Thanks for watching.